Hello students, welcome to Eternal Easy Education. In this session, you are going to learn Chapter 11, Database Concepts. So, content of this video is components of DBMS and types of data model. So, what are the components of DBMS? There are five components in a DBMS: hardware, software, data, procedures or methods, accessing language. So let me see what are the components and what is the necessity for the components to have a DBMS. So the DBMS can be divided into four major components. So first we need a hardware. What is that? It's a hard disk or I/O channel for data. That means involved in storage of data. First, we need a physical component to store the data, that is the hardware. Next one is software. The main component is a program that controls everything. The DBMS software is capable of understanding the database access language. Yes, the database access language is maintained or understand by the DBMS. That means that DBMS software and the database accessing language are interlinked and interrupt into database commands for execution. That means we need first a storage place, that is the physical component hardware. Next, we need the software to manipulate the hardware and also to maintain the data. So without, as you know, I'll ask a question. Can you tell me a computer is a software or a hardware? Then many people will give different kinds of answer, but actually a computer is a electronic device. So it's a hardware, but it's useless without a software. So we need a hardware part for the storage, then we need the software component. Then only we can have a DBMS concept for our real-time working principle. So hardware, software are there. Next we need the data. Software is ready, hardware is ready. Then we need the data which is going to be stored in the hardware as well as which is going to be manipulated by the DBMS. It is the resource for which DBMS is designed. DBMS creation is to store and utilize data. So DBMS creation is to store and utilize data. Next, procedure and methods. They are general instruction to use a DBMS management system, such as installation of DBMS. Manage database to take backups, report generation, etc. So we know we are having the hardware, we are having the software. Then we know the data which is going to be stored and utilized by the DBMS. Then the software should be installed in the particular hardware. Next step. Next, DBMS access language. They are the language used to write commands to access, insert, update and delete. That means we know that data is going to be stored in the form of tables. To store the data, to retrieve the data, to update, to delete, everything. Each event or each command or each thing is necessary. It should be inserted, it should be updated, it should be deleted, as well as it should be retrieved. So this is done by using the accessing language, that is the SQL queries. So all the five components together form a perfect DBMS management system. So if we feel that I need a database management for my project, then you must know all the five components. You should have a system with the hardware to store, with the hard disk to store the data. Then you should know the DBMS software. There are many softwares, MySQL, Oracle, SQL, there are many. We are going to discuss this later. So we must know which language, which database software you are going to use. Then you must know for which the database is created, for a student detail or for an employee or for any number of citizens for a government website. So these things should be analyzed. Then you should install the DBMS and there will be some procedure. After that, you have to choose the accessing language to write the coding. So these are the requirements to have a DBMS. Next, popular DBMS, they have given us DBase and FoxPro. That means the software which are used to maintain the data in the format of table or DBase and FoxPro. These are all DBMS, database management system softwares. Then database structure. As you know already, table is the entire collection of related data in one table, referred to as file. So this is important, table as well as known as file. So it is a collection of related data. A table where the data is organized in row and column. So if it is a table, then there must be a collection of rows and columns. It's mandatory. So without row and column, we cannot form a table. Next, each row in a table represents a record. Yes, row is called as record, which is a set of data for which database, for each database entry. Next, each table column is said to be the field or the heading, which groups each piece or item of data among the records into specific categories. So the important terms are: table is known as a relation, row is known as tuple, column is known as attribute. So here you see the example. So which is a column here? Yes, you are right. Student number, student name, student age, student class, and student section. These are all column name or attribute name. So each student or the horizontal record is said to be the row or tuple. So the column and the row or the attributes or the tuple all together forms a table or a relation. So this is the structure of a database. So if many tables are formed under a database, then the database is a collection of tables and we can have relationship between the tables. Next concept is data model. So the data model describes how the data can be represented and accessed from a software after complete implementation. So this model describes how the data can be represented, or simply how the relationship is made. It is a simple abstraction of complex real-world data gathering environment. The main purpose of data model is to give an idea as how the final system or software will look like after development is completed. So data model must be created before creating the tables. For example, if we are going to maintain a database for a bank, then you must have an idea which is a table. That means the manager is going to handle the table. That means the customer detail. The detail must be A to Z. Joining date, name, phone number, age, address, other card, etc., etc. Everything in a table. So manager will have all the access. But the person who is below his level or the next person will not access all the records. He will access only the person name and the account number and the amount. So there will be some structure to be formed. That structure is formed using the data model. Okay, it's going to be the blueprint of a software which is going to be developed, or blueprint of the database which is going to be developed for a particular organization. So what are the types of data model? Hierarchical, relational, network, and entity relationship This is said to be ER model. Next one is object model. So how many data type models are available? 5. Hierarchical, relational, network, entity, relationship, object. So what is a hierarchical model? Hierarchical model was developed by IBM as information, that is, the full form of IBM is information management system. Then hierarchical model, data is represented as simple tree like structure. This model represent one to many relationship, that is a parent child relationship. A parent can have single child or more than a single child. One child can have only one parent, so that is one to many. But one parent can have many children. This model is mainly used in IBM mainframe computers. So these are the key points. So here there is a structure. This is a tree structure. First, the base is school. The school is having a database. It is having a table. From that, we can have a course and resource. From the course, we can have a theory and the lab. So there will be only one parent, that is the school. This model is said to be hierarchical. Is it clear, children? Tree-like structure, one to many, that means a parent. A parent can have any number of children. So it will be in the structure. Next one is relational model. So relational database model was proposed by E.F. Codd in 1970. Nowadays, it was most widespread data model used for database applications around the world. The basic structure of data in relational model is tables. All the information related to a particular type is stored in rows of the table. Hence, tables are also known as relations in a relational model. A relational key is an attribute which uniquely identifies a particular table. Come here. In the relational model, as from the name, relational, it is going to form the relation between the table. How to form the relation means through a relational key. Okay. This relational key means it can be a primary key, foreign key. You are going to learn these things. Just have a gist. Relational model means tables are related through the relational key. Here see a table. Example, student ID, name, age. Here is another table, student ID, name and the teacher. Here student ID, subject ID and the marks. Here there is a student ID, here there is a subject ID. Okay, here it is student, name, age, here subject, name and the teacher. So student ID and subject ID, here is the marks. So this student ID and the subject ID are linked with the other table. So this method of relationship, or this model of database formation, is said to be relational database. So relational database, it's a basic structure of data in relational model is table, because table is a relation and it is forming the relationship using a relational key. Okay, the relational key means which uniquely identifies the particular tuple. Means a record. That means in this table the names are Malar, Sankar, Willow. The same Malar name can come again, because two students can have a same name, but the student ID remains to be unique, because the student ID 1 is given to only one student. No two students can have same ID. So it remains unique. As well as if the student ID 2 means it represents only one student. So, which uniquely identifies a particular tubule means particular record. Here subject ID. Subject ID 2 is given only for PHP. So here also subject ID is going to be unique. So the both keys are linked with other table. Okay, is it clear? Then network model. So network database model is an extended form of hierarchical data model. So extended form of hierarchical data model. The difference between hierarchical and network data model is, in hierarchical model, the child record has only one parent. Okay. Here, in network model, child may have many parents. That is one to many here. It's different. It represents the data in many to many relationship. So it is many to many relationship. Or else we can say it as a graph. Here it is tree. Here it is said to be tree structure. Am I right? Same network can be called as graph. So, what is the difference? Hierarchical is child have only one parent, one to many. Here, child may have many parent, that is many to many. School is there. From the school library, office, staff room. But student is derived from or having a link with library as well as with the office as well as with the staff room. So if the formation is in this method, then it is said to be network data model. School represents the parent node. Library, office and staff room are child to the parent node. The student is a child to library as well as office as well as staff room. So one to many is here. So it's a network data model. Then entity relationship, simply ER model. In this database model, relationship are created by dividing the object into entity and its characteristics into attributes. Do you remember this? Object into entity and characteristics into attributes. We'll see in elaborate. It was developed by Chen in 1976. This model is useful in developing a conceptual design for the database. It is very simple and easy to design logical view of data. The developer can easily understand the system by looking at ER model construct. That means if the database model is based on ER, then the development will be very easy. That means the development of coding for that or the tables or development of creation of the table for the particular database is very easy. Just like our flowchart, in ER model, there are some representations. That is, rectangle represents an entity. What is the entity? Doctor and patient, they are given like this. Here, see the example. Doctor, it is a table. From this table is having two attributes. Doctor ID, doctor name. And there is a patient database. That means table. Patient table. And it is having two attributes. Patient ID and patient name. The relationship between the doctor and the patient is the diagnosis. Now, come here. Rectangle represents the entities. That means the table, doctor and patient. Ellipse represents the attributes. Ellipse represents the attributes. That is doctor ID, doctor name, patient ID, patient name. You understand? It's given like a flowchart. As we know, flowchart is having a special meaning. Okay. Likewise, in ER model also, the representation should be based on this diagram. This is said to be ER diagram. So the table is represented by the rectangle. So there are two tables, and it is having attributes, that is an ellipse, and the relationship is mentioned with the diamond shape. Attribute describes the characteristics. Attributes describes the characteristics, and each entity becomes a major part of data stored in the database. Diamond represents the relationship in the ER model. So it will be very interesting when we frame this type of diagram. After that, creating a table will be very easy. So what is the entity relationship model? Simply, it is ER model. Here, the relationship and the structure of the table are represented through ER diagram. Then rectangle shape is for entities, that is for the table. Ellipse is for the attributes. Here the attribute describes the characteristics. Entity represents the table. Sometimes the entity will be a name of a person, name of an object. So diamond represents the relationship between the tables. So next is object model. So object model stores the data in the form of objects, attributes and methods, classes and inheritance. So in the object model, we can have all the concepts like object, attributes, methods. As we know, class is a collection of attributes and methods, and object is used to access the attributes and methods of a class. So inheritance is a concept of deriving a new class from an old class. These are all the concepts you have learned in C++. The same methodology is going to be implemented in tables. This model handles more complex applications such as geographic information system, that is GIS, scientific experiments, engineering design and manufacturing. So to create the database for the complex applications like GIS, scientific experiments, engineering design, object data model is used. It is used in file management system. It represents real world objects, attributes and behaviors. It provides a clear modular structure. So it provides a clear modular structure. It is easy to maintain and modify the existing code. So here there is an example. For example, they are given a shape. If it is a shape table, then it will have a get area and get perimeter. Then from that, we can have a circle. The shape may be a circle, the shape may be a rectangle, the shape may be a triangle. So its attributes are radius, here it is length and breadth, here it is base and height. So even the get area and get perimeter, that is from the radius we are going to calculate the area and perimeter of a circle, from here we are going to calculate the area and perimeter of a rectangle. So if the database is in this formation, we can use the object model, object data model. So an example of object model is shape, circle, rectangle and triangle are all objects. So circle has an attribute as radius, rectangle has attributes of length and breadth, triangle has attributes base and height. So the object circle, rectangle, triangle inherit from the object shape. But the thing is, we are not going to create an object data model. we are going to see the ER model in the syllabus. That means how to create the table and how to form the relationship. Is it clear, children? It's only on theoretical basis. Just remember the diagram. By the diagram itself, you can easily give the points for the data models. So how many data models are there? Hierarchical data model, relational data model, network database, relation entity relationship, that is ER model, then object oriented model. So you have learned what are the types of data model, what are the components of DBMS. So that's all for this session. Learn this well. Thank you.